Now, the next thing is the example of Hamming code which we are going to study is this. We have to construct a Hamming code for the data 1001 for the even parity, right? It is clearly mentioned in the question that we have to generate an even parity, but kadi at the very last of the example, correct? Now see, what is the first step? Can anybody tell me what will be my first step to solve this example? Am I audible?
Count message bits.
Count message bits. Okay, that will be my bit.
Right. Then find parity bit.
Yeah.
So this is using formula.
Okay. This is for the message which is given to us, right? How many number of bits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my M will be 5. Is that clear? This thing is clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Now, next thing is what we have to find the number of parity bits. Correct. How to find how many number of parity bits we are going to use in this given data by using this formula. Simple. So what is that formula? 2 raised to p. That should be always greater than or equal to p plus m plus 1. Right. What is p? We have to find it. What is m? 5 and plus 1. So I just directly consider 2 raised to 4. You can just do your own calculation. But 2 raised to 4, once you did this, what is 2 raised to 4?
16.
Right. P we consider 4, so 4 plus 5 plus 1, the answer is 10. This example or this formula is satisfied the condition, right? 16 is greater than 10. Yeah, so that is why my parity bits will be 4. Now, just for your understanding, consider P is equal to 3. 2 raised to 3 is greater than or equal to 3 plus 5 plus 1. How much it is?
9.
Right. 2 raised to 3 is your 8. And is the 8 is greater or equal to 9? No. Yes. 2 raised to 3 is your 8, right? So 3 plus 5 plus 1. How much it is?
3
plus
9.
5 plus 9. 1. That is 9. So 8 is not greater than or equal to 9. That is why we cannot take P is equal to 3. That is why I jump to directly P is equal to 4. Once, if I just put P is equal to 4, in that case, what will be my condition or what will be the answer? That the given equation or the given formula is satisfy the condition. That is why I'll consider my P is equal to 4. Number of parity bits which we are going to use in the given data will be 4. Right? So now everyone is clear with this. M is equal to 5 and P is equal to 4.
Yes, ma'am.
So next step will be, we have to put the parity bits. At which position? Can anybody tell me?
Power of 2. Power.
Right. 2's power.
So, 2 power on the places of 2 power, we have to put our parity bits. Now see, how many number of total bits we are going to have?
9.
How?
For parity bit plus message bit
plus parity bit.
Correct. 5 plus 4, that will be total 9 bits we are going to transmit. Right, so out of that 9, we have to put our we have to consider the position of parity bits, that the position of 2 power places 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3. What is 2 raised to 0? 1. 2 raised to 1? 2. 2 raised to 2? 4. 2 raised to 3? 8. You understand what we did here? Or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, now. So this is what my first position, and I will put my first parity bit here at this position, at the very first position. Now this is the second, I will put my second parity bit. Now 3 is not there because 3 is not 2 power place, right? Now 4 will be my next number, and next parity bit is P3. So I will put my next parity bit at the position of 4, correct? After 4, 5, 6, 7, these 3 are not again 2 power places. I'm not saying multiple of 2. So if I just say multiple of 2, 6 will be there because 2 into 3 will be 6. But we have to consider 2 power places. 2 raised to 0, 1, 2, 3. Right? 2 raised to 2 is 4 and 2 raised to 3 is 8. That is why we are going to skip the middle things, the middle term. Correct? Yes or no? Karan Samaj Laka, why we not put the parity bit at the position of 5, 6 and 7? Why we directly put it to the 8? Samaj Laka?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yeah. Now, right. Now, next thing is what? 2 raised to 3 is 8. At this position, I will put my 4th parity bit. So, 4 parity bits we are going to have total, and we just find the position of all the 4 parity bits. At the remaining position, the message signal is correct. 1, 3, 4, 8 is nothing but my position of parity bits, and the remaining positions will be of
message bits.
Correct. So, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. This is what is my message. What is M1? See the data. 10011. 10011. So this is my M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Correct. So I will directly put M1 is equal to 1, M2 is equal to 0, M3 is equal to 0, M4 is equal to 1, and M5 is equal to 1. Yes? Understand, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
What will be my resultant data at this step? P1, P2, 1, P3, 0, 0, 1, P4, 1. See, P1, P2, 1, P3, 0, 0, 1, P4, 1. This is what is my data. Now, next thing what we have to do? What will be my next step?
Find parity bit P1, P2.
Correct. We have to find the value of P1, P2, P3. Now, how to find the value of P1, P2, P3 is the next question. Right? How many number of parity bits you have?
Four.
So, we have to consider 4-bit binary equivalent. Right? What is 4-bit binary equivalent? To represent 1, I have to consider 0, 0, 0, 1. To represent 2, I have to consider 0, 0, 1, 0. For 3, it is 0, 0, 1, 1. Are you aware of this thing?
Yes.
Yes. So likewise, you have to consider all the bits till 9, because the maximum limit of bits we are going to have is 9. So how to represent 4? Can anybody tell me?
0, 1, 0, 0.
Right. 0, 1, 0, 0. How to represent 5?
0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 6 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 7 0 0 1 1 8 1 0 0 1 0 0 0
right. 1 0 0 0 and the last one is your 9, and that is 1 0 0 0 0 1. Right. तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना माहिती त्यासाठी मी सेपरेट पेज म्हणजे सेपरेट लिहिलेलं नाहीये. Everyone is aware of this thing. Now, why we are going to need this? लक्षात घ्या, लास्ट एक्झाम्पल मध्ये आपल्याकडे नंबर ऑफ पॅरिटी बिट्स किती होते? 3. करेक्ट. आपण काल जे एक्झाम्पल बघितलं, इन दॅट नंबर ऑफ पॅरिटी बिट्स वेअर 3. सो वी जस्ट कन्सिडर टू रिप्रेझेंट 1, वी यूज 001. 3 बिट होते पॅरिटी बिट्स, म्हणून 3-bit बायनरी नंबर वापरला आपण. हिअर वी हॅव पॅरिटी इज इक्वल टू 4-bit, दॅट इज वाय वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर 4-bit बायनरी डेटा. जर पॅरिटी बिट माझे 2 असतील, सो वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर 2-bit बायनरी इक्वलंट, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. राईट. लाईक वाईज यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर. सगळ्यांना समजलंय का हे?
येस मॅम.
पॅरिटी बिट जर 4 होते, देन इन दॅट केस आय विल यूज द 4-bit binary equivalent. Now, आपल्याला काय फाइंड करायचंय? P1, P2, P3, P4. Whatever is my last column, that will represent my P1. This represents my P2. This represents P3. And this represents P4. See, last example मध्ये मी तुम्हाला काय सांगितलं होतं? डायरेक्ट दिलं होतं P1 जर तुम्हाला वापरायचं असेल, सो P1 विल बी 1357. हे स्टँडर्ड आहे, मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं होतं बरोबर. 1357 P1 जर लिहायचं असेल तुम्हाला, तर यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर 1357 प्लेसेस. कोणतरी मला विचारलं पण होतं की हे फिक्स आहे का, बरोबर आठवत का? हा. सो हे फिक्स्डच असतं, या दीज व्हॅल्यूज आर स्टँडर्ड व्हॅल्यूज विच आर फिक्स्ड, पण त्या आल्या कुठून? त्यासाठी हा टेबल आहे. राईट. आता टू रिप्रेझेंट P1, जिथे जिथे 1 आहे Ata, there is a 1 at first position. So for P1, I will consider first. Okay. After that, at third position, there is 1. Second line, ka 1? Nahi. Put hai 1? Third line. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Is samajla ka? Ki nahi samajla?
Samajla.
Second, need baga. Kai lihle. Nahi samajla. Okay. I'll repeat it again. What we have to do, हे इतपर्यंत समजलं का P1 साठी काय P2 P3 P4 हे जे चार कॉलम आहे दॅट विल इंडिव्हिज्युअली रिप्रेझेंट P1 P2 P3 P4 इतपर्यंत क्लिअर आहे?
हो
गुणवंत आहे का गेला गुणवंत
आहे मॅम
इतपर्यंत समजलं का सगळ्यांना P1 P2 P3 P4 साठी each and every individual column represent P1, this second column represent P2, third column represent P3 and fourth column represent P4. Barabar? Now, ata P1 sati data kasa achieve karayacha? How to find P1? We have to consider the column which is representing P1. Ha last column jo hai to consider karayacha fakta. Last column madhe jithe jithe 1 hai, tya positions lahayacha. This is 1. Konta position lahay? First position. Namun mei tya 1 lila. त्याच्यानंतर सेकंडला 1 आहे का सेकंड पोझिशनला 0 आहे स्किप देर इज अ 1 ऍट थर्ड पोझिशन म्हणून इथे 3 नंबर लिहिला राईट देर इज 0 ऍट 4 स्किप आफ्टर दॅट 5 ला 1 आहे म्हणून 5 लिहिला 6 ला 0 आहे सोडून दिला 7 ला 1 आहे वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर 7 नंतर लास्ट कुठला आहे 8 ला नाही आहे 9 ला यू हॅव 1 आता समजलंय काय केलं
Yes, ma'am.
हो मॅम
नसेल समजलं तर परत विचार मी परत सांगते समजलं का ओके नाउ द वे वी यूज टू रिप्रेझेंट P1 इज द सेम वे वी हॅव टू यूज टू रिप्रेझेंट P2 P3 अँड P4 कसं टू रिप्रेझेंट P2 आय विल कन्सिडर सेकंड कॉलम सेकंड कॉलम मध्ये जिथे जिथे 1 आहे त्या त्या पोझिशन लिहून काढायच्या कुठे 1 आहे बघा सेकंड कॉलम इथे 2 1 आहेत कुठे 2 आणि 3 सो 2 3 माय 2 डिजिट्स राईट त्याच्यानंतर 0 0 इथे 1 आहे 6 ला 1 आहे 7 ला 1 आहे सो 6 7 नंतर आय का 1 कुठे नाहीये कळालं P2 कसा लिहिला समजलं का की नाही समजलं P2
हो मॅम
हो मॅम समजलं
सेम वी हॅव टू यूज फॉर P3 विच कॉलम आय विल कन्सिडर फॉर P3 थर्ड कॉलम मध्ये जिथे जिथे 1 आहेत त्या त्या पोझिशन लिहून काढायच्या सी 4 5 6 7 बरोबर 4 5 6 7 आता हा कॉलम तुम्ही जेव्हा नीट लिहाल तेव्हा तुम्हाला इझिली समजेल तुम्ही आता त्याच्यावरच ओव्हर राईट केले दॅट इज इट इज क्वाईट कॉम्प्लेक्सिंग पण तुम्ही जेव्हा एक्झाम्पल नोटबुक मध्ये सॉल्व्ह कराल इन दॅट टाइम ऍट दॅट टाइम यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टँड इझिली हाऊ टू रिप्रेझेंट 4 4 चा डेटा सांगा बरं मला काय येईल
8 9 8 and 9
ओनली 2 डिजिट्स विल बी देअर एम आय राईट कारण फोर्थ कॉलम जो आहे सगळे 0 आहेत फक्त 8 आणि 9 हे दोघंच 1 आहेत बरोबर का म्हणून P4 साठी आय विल कन्सिडर ओनली 8 and 9 एव्हरी वन इज क्लिअर विथ दिस हाऊ टू रिप्रेझेंट P1 P2 P3 P4 राईट नाव हा डेटा कसा आला हे माहिती आहे सगळ्यांना P1 P2 1 P3 0 0 1 P4 1 आपण इथे अचीव केला आता इथे लिहिला हे सगळं आपण केलं इथपर्यंत 2 पॉवर प्लेसेस वगैरे फाइंड केल्या वी हॅव टू फाइंड द पोझिशन ऑफ पॅरिटी बिट्स करेक्ट नाव व्हॉट इज द डिजिट ऍट फर्स्ट प्लेस
P1
व्हॉट इज द डिजिट ऍट थर्ड प्लेस
1
At fifth place?
0.
Seventh place?
1.
And ninth place also there is?
1.
Everybody getting this or no? हे कसं लिहिलं हे?
Yes,
everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, see this in the question it is clearly mentioned that you have to construct an hamming code for the data 10011 for even parity right now if I want to generate the even parity from this what should be the value of p1 one.
Why? Tell me the reason also. Because when P1 1, 1 is the value 4, and 4 is even number. So right. It is even parity.
Right. If I just consider P1 is equal to 1, the total number of 1s in the given set will be 4, and 4 is my even number. Right. That is why I have to consider P1 is equal to 1. Everybody is getting this or no? We are solving ma'am. Second example of hamming code. Right. So even odd parity to tumhala ta alas pahiche. Now second, P2 sati apan we have achieved this data 2, 3, 6, 7. Write down the what is the value of position, what is the value at the position 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. P2, 1, 0, 1. Yeah? P2, 1, 0, 1. 2, 3, 6, 7 position. Right? Now, if I want to generate an even parity from this, what should be the value of P2?
0.
0.
Tell me the reason also.
Number when of we one consider is two. P2 is 0, then number of 1 remains 2. That's why. And it is even parity. Even number.
Even number.
Very good. Now, the last, third parity bit. For third parity bit, we have achieved the position 4, 5, 6, 7. At 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 5, 6, 7. P3, 0, 0, 1. P3, 0, 0, 1. Right. Now, what should be the value of P3?
1.
1.
Right. So, if I just consider P3 is equal to 1, then and then only total number of 1s in the given set will be 2. And 2 is even parity. That is why P3 my 1. Right. And for P1, we have 8, 9. What is the value of 8 and 9 position? P4, 1. P4, 1. P4 should be?
1.
1 for even parity. Right now the final message signal will be now ata ha jo kai data aplyakade see in that we have achieved value of p1 p2 p3 p4 milala ka value tumhala p1 p2 p3 p4 cha yes you have achieved the values of all the parity bits now you have to put those values in the set what is p1 1 after that what is p2 0 the next digit is my message signal which is 1 after that what is p3 1 What is P4? Oh, sorry, the next bit? 0. What is next bit? 0. What is 7th bit? 1. What is P4? It is 1. And lastly, 1. So this is what is the data. Hey, samajh gaya kasa lihna mi?
Oh.
Right? Ata ha jo maza data hai. How many number of bits are there in the data? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here we have calculated total 9 bits we are going to have. Do we have 9 bits?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, and this is the data which you are going to actually transmit while communication. Right, the final message signal will be see 101, 101, after that 100, 100, and 111, 111. Right? So this is what is your hamming code. No matter how many number of message bits are given to you, jevde number of message bits asel, from that you are going to calculate number of parity bits. And once you are, once you know the number of parity bits, you can easily calculate the message which you have to transmit. Yes. Ata he example samajle. Kal tune ekada example solve karaycha.
Samajle ma'am.
Sagyanna.
मॅम जर पॅरिटी बीट जर मोर दॅन 4 असेल तर बायनरी बीट्स पण मोर दॅन 4 घ्यायचं का
येस जेवढे नंबर ऑफ पॅरिटी बीट्स तेवढा तुमचा बायनरी डेटा येणार आहे पण लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग तुम्हाला एग्जाम मध्ये पॅरिटी बीट्स तुमचे 3 किंवा 4 असतात मॅक्सिमम आतापर्यंत तर फक्त 3च विचारले 4 तर कधी विचारलेलं पण नाहीये पण इन केस जर विचारलं तर काय करायचं म्हणून तुम्हाला मी एक्झाम्पल घेतले बुक मध्ये आहे कारण एक्झाम्पल विचारत तर नाही तुम्हाला एक्झामला पण 3 बीटचं विचारतात तुम्हाला मोस्टली जेवढे नंबर ऑफ पॅरिटी बिट्स जास्त तेवढं तुमचा बायनरी डेटा ओके समजलं सगळ्यांना सगळं हो नाही काहीतरी म्हणा
समझ लो मैम.
सो शैल वी फिनिश द लेक्चर हियर इटसेल्फ.
यस मैम.
लिंक पाठवलं होतं ते मागच्या लेक्चर प्रीवियस लेक्चर चे म्हणजे
पाठवले ग्रुपवर बघते जरा बघ पाठवले मिळाली नाही का तुम्हाला कोणाला
मिळाली मॅम
मग मी कामं केली आहेत माझी आता तुमचे कामं सुरू झाली.